Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is that time of year again. The time of year when Muslims are asked by their classmates, their teachers, and their friends, what are you doing for Halloween? Are you going to your relatives for Thanksgiving? What are you getting for Christmas? Let's understand some of the holidays that are celebrated in the non-Muslim countries as well as in the Muslim world. Halloween is a religious holiday originating from the ancient Celtic festival of Samhain. Thanksgiving is not a religious holiday. It only celebrates certain parts of American history. Hanukkah and Christmas. Both these holidays are from religions other than Islam.
Is it halal for us to celebrate these holidays or not?
When we say when an action is halal or haram, it means that there is either a reward or a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Deciding if things are halal or haram is not up to us. We don't get to choose what is halal and haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses for us. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر. Ali Imran, verse 110. This translates to, you are the best ummah that has been raised up for mankind. You enjoin the good and forbid the evil. In the hereafter, paradise or hell is awaiting those who obey or disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we say haram, this means that there is a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is something we cannot do because it means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry at those who do the haram and means that he will punish us. Before celebrating any holiday, before taking an action related to the holiday, we must ask ourselves, is it halal or haram? Are we obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or disobeying him? We should question ourselves when we think about doing haram things like stealing, eating pork, or not praying. So let's group the holidays so we can better understand if they are haram or halal. The days that are celebrated can be put into two categories. The first is the celebration of a religious holiday, such as Christmas, Good Friday, Easter, etc. In Islam, we only have two Eids, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. So any day that has a connection to a religion other than with Islam is haram to celebrate. Christmas, Hanukkah, Easter, etc. are all connected to an act of worship outside Islam and are haram. The second category does not have a religious connection but is connected to a culture or history such as Independence Day, Arab Revolution Day, or a national day. These national holidays are haram to celebrate. In some countries, these national holidays are even called Eids. For example, in Jordan, it is considered Eid al-Ummal. The Arab Revolution Day is referred to as Arab Revolution Eid. In history, the revolutions led to the splitting up of Muslims into different countries and away from Islam. This is not something to be celebrated or appreciated. As for celebrating Thanksgiving, it signifies the taking of someone else's land, killing the American Indians, or making them into slaves, Muslims as well as non-Muslims. So it is not to be celebrated. Now the issue here is if it is allowed for us to eat turkey or not. It is permitted for us to eat turkey any day of the year. However, having it on Thanksgiving Day is imitating a haram action and is forbidden.
So in summary, what does Islam say about the holidays and what we can and cannot celebrate?
First, imitating the kuffar in any of their religious affairs is forbidden. Al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih book that Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu reported that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you will indeed follow the ways of those before you, hand span by hand span, and an arm's length after another. Even if they enter into a lizard's hole, you will follow them. We asked, is it the Jews and the Christians? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, who else? There are many Islamic evidences that forbid the Muslims from celebrating holidays other than Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Al-Bayhaqi reported in his Sunan that Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu said, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, the people had two holidays from the days of Jahiliyyah. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when I came to you, you had 2 days which you used to celebrate in Jahiliyyah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has replaced them for you with better days, the days of slaughter, Adha, and the day of Fitr. Also, Imam Ahmad in his Musnad reported that Aqba bin Amir radiallahu anhu reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to have said, the day of Fitr and the days of Tashriq are our holidays, the people of Islam. These evidences are clear in forbidding the Muslims to have any Eid than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed for them. Thus, we are not allowed to participate in or celebrate the holidays of the non-Muslims. We are not allowed to attend their festivals.
How should Muslims celebrate the two Eids?
Enjoy the days of Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. Spread the love and warmth to your family, friends, and those close to you. Remember often the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, and also remember the responsibilities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed upon us to provide for those who have little. Enjoy the days of Eid al-Adha by observing the rules that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for these days, but also remember the responsibility to establish all the rules of Islam, for this will be the true enjoyment.